Next one is the error detection. In error detection technique, we are using two programs. At the sender type, sender, we are using generator, and at the receiver, we are using checker. Both are having some programs. Okay. Now, what the generator will do? It will convert the data word into code word. For each data word, there is a specific code word that it will convert the into code words. At the receiving end, it will checks. It will take the code word from the receiver and check with the list of valid code words. If this code word received is matched with the valid code word, it will just extract the redundant bits from the code word and create a data word and send it to the receiver end here. If the code word is not matched with the valid one, that is invalid one it is, then it is just discarded here. However, the code word is corrupted during transmission, but received word is still matches with the valid code word, the error remains undetected. What is the meaning here? To understand it very easily, I just give a small example here. Now, you are sending some alphabets, a capital alphabets A to Z, just imagine here. Now, if the sender send a capital A, during transmission, it is converted into capital F. The checker thinks that the received word F is a valid word because it's from alphabet. So it is just received it instead of discard it. Because A is converted to F, F is also a valid code word, it will accept it. Such problem occurs in the error detection. An error detecting code can detect only the type of error for which it is designed. The other type of error may remain undetected. Okay, I will explain with some example here. If these are the 2-bit data words, okay, these are the 2-bit data words I have to transmit. It is converted into code word in this fashion. For example, if I want to transmit 00, it is always, the generator always convert it into 000. In similar fashion, if I want to transmit 10, the generator always convert that into code word called as 101. It never convert any other code word. It always converted into 101. These are the valid code words. For these data words, these are the valid code words. In this code word, some invalid code words are also there. For example, 001 is an invalid code word. 010 is an invalid code word. 111 is an invalid code word. Like that, many invalid code words are here. Only 4 code words are valid here. The remaining are invalid. Okay, now, according to this example, we assume that our data word is actually 2, a size of 2. Now, the code word size is 3, 3 bits. Now, if the sender wants to transmit 01 to the receiver, so what he will do, he will convert into code word called as 011. If the receiver got the same code word, that is 011. If receiver got the code word 011, the checker matches this list. The checker already contain a list of this valid code words. It will just matches with the list. Here it will match with the 011. That means it's a valid code word and accept it. Okay. Now, if during transmission, during transmission, the 011 becomes 111. The first bit is changed from 0 to 1. Okay. When the receiver got 111, this 111 as a code word, it checks in the list. It's an invalid code word. 111 is an invalid code word. So the checker understood that it is corrupted. Okay. In the same similar fashion, one more example. If you are sending 01 data word and it is converted into 011 at the sender area. During transmission, these two bits 11 is changed to 00. The output code word becomes 000, which is received by the receiver. Receiver think that the sender send this 00 as the code word. It's a valid code word. Okay, actually you are sending 01, but the receiver thinks that it's a 000 is a valid code word. It just removed the redundant bit here and converted into 00 and send it to the receiver. Such thing happens during data transmission.